Leviton offers a variety of quick port and 110 style patch panels in both flat and angled versions. In this video, we'll demonstrate how to successfully terminate a flat patch panel and share some tips and tricks. For this termination, we'll be using a data wire strip tool, a 110 punch down tool, and a pair of flush cutters. Due to the larger size of category 6A cables, you cannot run wiring from a single side of the rack. Instead, terminate the cable running down the left-hand side of the rack from the center of the patch panel out toward the left, and the cabling running down the right-hand side of the rack from the center out toward the right. With the angled patch panel, it's the opposite. When terminating wires on the right side of the panel, use the cable running down the left side of the rack. This avoids having to bend the cables nearly 180 degrees to reach the IDCs. The same principle would apply to terminating an angled quick port patch panel. Using the category 6A cable from the left side of the rack, terminate the bottom outboard connector on the left side of the flat category 6A panel first. Following this, terminate the top outboard connector, then the second connector on the bottom, then the second one on the top, and so forth. Following this zigzag pattern allows you to build up the cables in a way that maintains the best possible organization. Using the cable bundle on the right, follow the same steps for the right-hand side of the panel. Start with the bottom outboard connector, then the top connector, then the second bottom one, and so forth until all of the cables are lying nicely on top of one another. Sweeping from the center of the panel out toward the right-hand side of the rack. For organization, we suggest working from the outside in by terminating all of the lower connectors first, followed by the top ones. To demonstrate using a single category 6A cable, first bring the cable in to estimate the necessary length, then cut off the excess cable. Next, strip the end about an inch using a data cable stripper by going around once. This should break the jacket and expose the conductors. With a set of flush cutters, prep the cable by cutting out any non-pair elements. These may be a strip string, a more traditional cross separator, or Mylar tape. In this case, there are three filler tubes to be cut out. A common mistake is to come into the IDCs from the side, but doing so leaves the blue pair short and the brown pair long. A better approach is to come down the center and splay the pairs out to where they are needed, as indicated by the colored marking on the IDC. This way all of the pairs end up being an appropriate similar length. Leviton's patch panels include pair separation towers, which can be used to help split pairs. Use the colors marked on the IDC, which align with the colors of the pairs, as a guide when splitting the pairs. Once correctly seated, punch down the pairs using a punch tool set to the low impact setting. Remember that the cut side of the punch tool must face down so that the excess end of the wire below the IDC is cut rather than inside toward the cable jacket. With the first pair punched into place, it will be easier to work with the other pairs. Following the colors indicated on the IDC, use the pair separation towers to split and punch all of the remaining wires. With the category 6A cable, it may require an extra punch to get through the thick insulation. An important reminder is to maintain the twists in the cable as much as possible. With one wire terminated, notice how the pairs have their twists left in them, how the wires come from the middle of the module out toward the IDC, and how the wires were cut below the IDC. For the connector above, you bring the cable in along the same line, but face the wires upward and turn the punch tool around to cut the wires above the IDC this time. Once the bottom and top wires are routed for the first module, move on to the second bottom module, followed by the second top module, and so on. This particular patch panel includes dust covers that snap over groups of three IDCs. Once a row is fully terminated, cover them to protect and secure the wiring and to provide an overall organized finish. For more information, please see www.leviton.com/copper.